Makes you mad?
All right, we just got the coordinates, the location. I said the coordinates. We got the location put into the GPS, and we're going to Stockton, California, down to Chico, California. Raley's or Raley's? I don't know what the fuck it is, man, but this is where we just finished dropping off. We're proceeding on with our day. We just woke up a little while ago, actually. And make sure you got your water on deck. Don't be all fucking dehydrated, driving and shit. Then you're wondering why the fuck you're all tired and shit. Man, take a sip of water. You'll see how much energy comes out. Like, bro, you ever take a sip of water? That shit go on the wrong side? You're like, damn, man. All defeated. It's fucking ridiculous. So we're gonna exit out. It looks like the better exit's that way, actually. I'm seeing that other truck driver exit over there. Fuck that. That shit looked a little tight right there. I'm straight off of that. We're going to the drop yard. Apparently, we got our preloaded trailer there. Peace out to Raley's, by the way, or Raley's. Apparently, they got our preloaded trailer there, and they gave us this little baby load. So I'm hoping that we can have another job ready to go, another load, as soon as we finish this one up. So if y'all don't know, I'm OTR position, man. You know, I can go all 48 states and I don't gotta be home for another 8 days. So I mean, they could send me somewhere in the center of the map, preferably to the south, maybe Louisiana or something. Texas, you know, they got a lot of loads in Texas. We got our Laredo drop yard over there too. It's not a drop yard, actually. It's actually a terminal in Laredo. Everybody got a terminal in Laredo, man. Every single company gotta have a terminal in Laredo. That place is always jam-packed. The density is just ridiculous over there. It's looking good right here. We good. I already checked the satellite image, and it looks like a little tight yard. But we'll see what's up. We'll see what's up. Great way to start the drive with green lights. Let's keep it going. No? All right. Low key, I'm kind of hungry, man. I'm not going to hold y'all, man, but a bagel with cream cheese. Yeah, that sounds fucking delicious. Are we going to keep that green? Yeah, we are. We in there. They got an In-N-Out over here. Fucking delicious, by the way. If y'all haven't had In-N-Out yet, y'all are tweaking. We're going into the 80 West, heading towards Stockton. Let's hope that trailer's good, man. Sometimes the, you know what I'm saying? You'll have some drivers drop the trailer off, man. Nasty ass tires. Tires that are ready to fucking blow out and shit. They got a fucking signal out. Like, man, that's that weak shit, man. That's that weak shit. I try to do my best when it comes down to inspecting equipment. You know, because I don't want to give problems to the next driver that ends up taking the trailer that I just, you know, dropped off or whatever. Let's see what this box truck's gonna do, man. He should have just accelerated already by now. I guess he's just gonna let me in now. He could have been gone right there. I was trying to let him go, but it's all good. Appreciate it, big dog. Exit 86. If y'all ever, look, learn how to use your turn signals, man. That's one pet peeve of mine right there. Learn how to use your damn turn signals. People will put their blinker on for one blink and then that's it. Like, fool, hold that shit, man. Let it blink all the way until you get in your lane and then you let it go. That's a pet peeve of mine, man. Quit doing that weak shit. That's that weak shit. Quit playing with it. You driving out here. Motherfuckers be way too comfortable on the road. Way too comfortable. Let's get out these guys' way, man. Now see, that shit's dangerous. That's that dangerous merge. Cause then they gotta yield to the freeway. Like, bro, you know, people are doing 65 plus in the freeway and you gotta merge and you're only merging doing 35? That's pretty ridiculous if you ask me. I don't mind driving in the city. I remember when I first started driving, you know, low-key it was intimidating driving in, you know, 4 or 5 lane highways, and you're out here in the center lane having traffic passing both ways. It used to definitely intimidate me. But now, man, just keep your eyes forward. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. Keep the truck straight. Don't be fucking up. Don't be fucking up on that weak shit, man. Got a little bridge right here. Got traffic coming to a halt. I'm gonna throw this, throw your hazards on, boys. When you see traffic coming to a halt like that, throw your hazards on, please. Do yourself the favor. Keep everyone safe. Everyone knows that there's some shit going down. They're gonna be more alert. So do yourself that favor right there. Look, see, you got a scene down there. I don't know if y'all can see it yet, but there's a scene down here. You got the police and shit. Nah, bro, you in a truck, bro, you better get over it. You better get over it. Don't be on that dumb shit. Yeah, they got a little scene going on. I wonder if it's like a little accident or something. That's the thing about being a truck driver, guys. Look at this fool. Look at this fool. Look at him. Look at him. You got to expect these people to just do shit like that. You got to. Look at this. You got a tanker right here, and this guy's just cutting into it. You got a dude in a dirt bike. Sheesh. Boy received the biggest back shot of his life right here. Look at him. All disappointed, fool. All bad day with it. All bad day with it. Here we go. Here we go. Look at this Camry. Look at it. Look at it. Bro, be extra cautious, man. Like, just keep your distance for no reason. It don't matter what everyone else thinks. It don't matter everyone coming around you, whatever. Bro, be safe. Don't put anyone at risk, man. Don't put anyone at risk. You don't want to be doing that to yourself. Just keep your distance. Look at this guy. He'll stop traffic just to get in. Look. He can't accept the fact that he missed his exit. And there you go. Doing all types of dumb shit. There you go. Alright. I seen this fucking Swift driver the other day, man. That dude just stopped in the median, like between the merge and on the ramps and shit, and he just completely stopped because he didn't want to miss that fucking that merge. All y'all who ride motorcycles, y'all some savages, man. I don't know how y'all do that shit. That shit is terrifying. One wrong maneuver, done. 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 Broken bones, all that, done. Either dead or broken bones. Something's going on, like, for sure. Alright, we just pulled up to the yard, the drop yard that I'm supposed to be picking up this trailer from, but I'm not really seeing this trailer here. It's probably gonna be somewhere back here though, that's for sure. More than likely, somewhere back here. Man. Ridiculous. See, in places like these, that's where you put the inner axle lock. Make sure we start moving good here. Yeah. It's got to be over here. I see a CR England right here, right now. This is interesting, man. I'm going to have to keep looking around because I definitely don't got the trailer. We can't find the trailer. I don't know where the trailer's at. I'm here sitting parked at the drop yard, and just looks like there's no trailer here. So maybe it'll be here later. I'm trying to get in contact with dispatch, but we'll see what's up. So looks like the trailer is not in this yard. I looked everywhere. I called dispatch. I let them know, hey man, like the trailer's not here. I looked at the different trailers to check the bill of ladings, and nothing in there as well, not what I was looking for. So the guy didn't confuse the trailer number, but we have a clue of where it might be. So I was talking to another CR England driver here, and he told me, hey man, maybe he possibly dropped it off at the old Stockton, California yard. I said, where's that at? He said, it's right by the Thermo King in Stockton. So I called dispatch, I let him know, hey, like, what if it's over there? And well, sure enough, he told me, that's not a bad idea to go check. So I'm gonna go check and see what's up. Let's see, if it's here, I'm gonna be surprised, man. We should be able to just drive straight in, because they don't have the code, so there's no way that they could have parked it in there. So if it's here, it's right in front of us. So let's see. Yep, there we go. It says drop yard right there. Drop yard. Watch it be here, man. Man, we found it, boys. We found it. Let's drop this empty off and proceed. Let's drop this empty off. Looks like you guys are gonna get some backing footage, boys. Wasn't a one shot, it was like a four shot. Alright. I need some coffee, dog. Some coffee sounds pretty good right now. I was wondering where my gloves were at. They're usually right there, but they're in my pocket. It's because I stay ready with it, fool. Ain't nothing but a G thing. Tell you, you gotta give it a few smacks. Put it through. You gotta stay solid with it, man. Couple of smacks, no biggie. Boom. Landing gear's not over there, but we do gotta pull this release arm. Listen, man, don't be yanking that release arm. Don't be all fucking, nah, man. Do it safely, you know what I'm saying? Like, you get in there and you're supposed to use your bicep to pull it. Don't yank your body, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're gonna pull a shoulder. You don't want to be pulling a shoulder and shit. How you pull a shoulder? Come on. Right here, fool, take it easy. Fool, take it easy. And it still looks like this is a drop yard. He said it's an old drop yard. To me, it still looks like it's a drop yard for CR England. Why, you may ask? Because I see a whole bunch of CR England trailers here. We unhook the airlines, pull the release arm, drop the landing gear, we're good to go. Oh, yep, we in there. Might be a little rough, fuck it. It wasn't as rough as I thought it could have been. Take this opportunity to tug test. Oh yeah, that's solid. One more time. Solid. All right, boys. got it. There we go, working good. They better give me a good trailer, man. This trailer is chilling at the Thermo King yard, so maybe there was something wrong with it they had to fix. Working. Working. It's good. That actually looks like a fairly new tire, man. Pull up on them with that. It's the correct one. Make sure our lights are working. Why is this shit dripping water? Yeah, that's just trucking for you guys, man. Let's just roll. Let's get out of here, then, first of all. I know, man. I be making my little coffee and shit at the Loves and shit. Hey, but I be a little too camera shy to bring the camera into the Loves. I don't know, man. It's a little too much. I know some people do that shit, but I don't know, man. I post the before and after, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll get up in there, I'll make my coffee, and I'll show y'all that I made my coffee, but I'm not gonna show y'all the process of making coffee. Like, y'all know how to make coffee. Come on. Don't play yourself. That Brazilian rich is just bomb. I tried that shit last night. That shit was fire. You know, a lot of times people think that truck drivers, all we do is drive. But man, it's the shit that happens before we drive that's what stresses us out, man. Not to mention our appointment time. So, you know, you gotta be able to log everything correctly, off duty, on duty, sleeper, driving, you know. You need to understand the technology and whatnot. You need to let them know when you arrive or when you leave to picking up the trailers and stuff. Like, you know, I'm just putting it in simple words, simple sentences. You know, driving is just like, that's the easy part, man. The hard part is backing up, trip planning. You gotta trip plan correctly, man. If you don't trip plan correctly, you might get yourself into something that's gonna be very difficult to get out of, you know? So if you come across a road closure or something and you didn't look ahead of time, you know, like, that's something that can definitely, you know, get you in some trouble, you know? And you don't wanna end up in trouble, I'll tell you that much. Little tiny ass streets. This thing's got me all lopsided and shit. Like, what is this? I don't feel safe. Stay. You gotta talk to them like dogs. Stay. Cause sometimes they just whoop, and then you out here gotta fucking hit the brakes all hard, and we can't even stop like that. Man, something is wrong with this fucking street, bro. Look at how lopsided I am, bro. I don't feel comfortable like this. Any little gust of wind, boop, oh, done. Fuck this. Thanks, man, thanks. Cause I gotta get over right here. Oh, just get over a little early. That way you're not worrying about getting over later. You know what I'm saying? Like, now don't overdo it, you know what I'm saying? But give yourself some time. Like, they got some tacos right there. Sheesh. Man, low key. Man, they got a good yard right there too. I could have low key stopped in there. Fucking up. Yes, sir. We in there like swimwear. Hey, be careful, Jeep. Watch yourself, man. Watch yourself. Thank you. We just got to the location. It's time to check in, boys. That's how you get out of that facility, boys. They unloaded me pretty quickly, man. It was a load of a whole bunch of oil. Looks like we're going to Washington, boys. We might be seeing some snow. Things are gonna get a little interesting, man. I'm pretty sure it should be icy at least over there, like some snow on the side of the road or something, possibly. I believe so. I don't really go up north like that. But we're gonna pass through Oregon. We're gonna get into Washington. And we're dropping off to a Walmart DC. We should be picking up this, it's another preloaded trailer in the same drop yard that I was at yesterday is where we're dropping this empty and picking up the preloaded and headed down to Oregon. Well, passing through Oregon and getting into Washington, dropping off at a Walmart. So let's get to it. It's about a 900 mile drive. Yo, we got like some construction over here on the right. I don't know how I'm gonna make this turn. I'm gonna have to just boss hog mad, like to the left of the opposing lane here, because it's gonna be a little tough. Went into the Loves, I got myself a coffee, and man am I silly, I'll tell you that much. I fucking dropped it. I got in the truck, I set it down on the floor. Why the hell would I set it down on the floor? I don't know, that was some dumb shit. That's that weak shit, man. But boom, it fell, whoop-de-whoop. Now I gotta go get a refill. And yeah, cleaning up the floor was a pain in the cheeks, man. It always feels good when you take a good ass shower, man. When that hot ass water started steaming, I was like, sheesh. These fools right here look like they're on a 10 right now. I'm looking at them right now. So we're gonna go in real fast and we're gonna grab this coffee refill and we out. Yep. I'm gonna go quick, real quick. Let's do this shit. We going, man. We need to get this coffee. Fuck all that. That's why you don't send a dude like me up north. Bro, you're in shorts. We got it, boys. We got it.
Parked right here. So we outro. We outro. Right here in shorts. 40 degrees.
I get that Brazilian rich. I put like 5 creamers of French vanilla in that shit. A few sugars. The blue pack. Stir it up. Take a quick sip. Usually that suffices. I can't believe I dropped my damn coffee, man. How the hell am I dropping my coffee like that? Not to mention, I had to use my towel, bro, to clean it up. Man, I don't even know if I'm gonna use that towel ever again. He's lucky he even found a spot at this time, because they be doing shit like that. I don't like it when people do things like that, man. That's low-key grimy, man. That's some selfish shit. Like, there's a truck spot, and they put a car in it. That way, they save their truck parking spot. I don't like that. Like, bro, people need to learn how to have some manners, yo. Especially because, you know, there's people like us. We're OTR, and we have trouble finding parking sometimes, depending on our schedules. You got people parking their cars in truck spots. I don't know who else does this, but I put a little bit of ice cubes in my coffee, man, because then that shit stays way too hot. Shout out to Love's Diamond. We all appreciate Love's Diamond status. Free coffee, free refills, free showers. 4 points per dollar spent. That shit's just so clutch. Take some time to trip plan real quick. What is this guy doing? I'm pretty confident I can get out, but it's still kind of sus. Let me go ahead and get pretty wide like this. Go like this. Make sure we look. We're good, boys. We're good. That dude was straight blocking everything up. It's all good. Appreciate y'all for watching this video. I'ma see y'all in Oregon. This has been Craft on Wheels. It's a pleasure to have you, my boy. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Smash that like button if you can. If you enjoyed. If you didn't, man, smack a dislike. I don't really care, man. It still moves the algorithm. But anyway, it don't really matter. And drop a comment if y'all have any questions on anything I said or any advice, because I'm a rookie. Any criticism or anything is greatly appreciated, because as a rookie, I don't know everything, and I'm very, very, very willing to learn and to, get better at my job. So let me know, boys. Appreciate y'all. It's been Craft on Wheels. We out.